Hello everyone. Today I will introduce to you a sculpture video about ethnic minorities in the Van Ha Giang Bronze Karst Plateau, Vietnam. Hmong ethnic sculpture is a stirring emotion in my soul when living and working with the indigenous ethnic minorities, and I transformed it through portraits on wood save image of the Hmong people. I saved the images of people going to the market in the highlands for use as documents. Hand-sculpted sculpture requires skill and perseverance in the steps of breaking the shape and the detailed steps of imitating the image. From the smallest details on the photo, the images of the Hmong people are identified through clothing and hats, and their facial structure is different from other ethnic groups. Historical origins of Hmong ethnic migration. The Hmong people are an ethnic minority in Vietnam. This ethnic group has a unique cultural tradition with a long history dating back thousands of years and over 300 years after settling from China in most of the northern mountainous provinces of Vietnam. I believe it regarding the ethnic name of this nation, there are many different views and explanations. Since ancient centuries, the Han people called the Hmong people Mio. When migrating to Vietnam, this ethnic name coincidentally coincided with the name of the Vietnamese cat. Therefore, most Hmong people did not like it. So they proposed that the government be called the way people call themselves Hmong people. But the word Hmong, if pronounced correctly in Hmong, is a nasal word, Hmongs. Meanwhile, the Vietnamese sub-sound system does not have any letters that can accurately record upper nasal sounds. Researchers borrowed the consonant, hem, to record the word Hmong. Therefore, when the state officially issued the list of Vietnamese ethnic groups, people read it phonetically, so the word Hmong became Hmong, Hmong. This way of calling once again makes many Hmong people hate the same word cat as before. I think it's time to have a stable name, consistent with the wishes of the Hmong people. If Vietnamese consonants cannot record the nasal sound of Hmong, Hmongs, then the currently used name should be accepted as Hmong. This will definitely make people more excited. According to some historical documents, the Mongol people appeared earliest in the Yellow River Basin, China. However, in the course of history, due to many reasons, the Hmong people had to migrate to the south, then became a descendant of one of the ancient indigenous peoples of South China, including the Hu Donjing, Hunan, Sichuan, Guizhou, Yunnan, Guangdong, Guangxi regions, China, In this region, the Hmong people once established their own nation, Tam Mu. But not long after being here, they moved south to Vietnam and other Southeast Asian countries. The Hmong people migrated to Vietnam in three largest periods. In the first period over 300 years ago, they migrated from Guizhou, China, to Dong Van, Ha Giang, Vietnam. During this period, the Hmong people in Guizhou were emerging in a movement to fight against the policy of land conversion and exile, abolishing the Hmong chief's regime. The court sent Han mandarins directly to rule, of the Qing dynasty, from 17th century to early 18th century, but failed. It can be said that Dong Van is where the Hmong people from China came to our country earlier than other localities. The second wave of migration was nearly 300 years ago. This time, the Hmong people entered Vietnam through two routes. One is to Dong Van district, Ha Giang. The second is to follow the Sima Kai, Bac Ha, Lao Cai Road. The origins of the Hmong people who migrated during this period were mostly in Guizhou, Yunnan, and Guangxi, China. Compared to Chinese history books, this period is consistent with the failed Mongol uprising in Guizhou, 1776 to 1820. The third migration period was about 200 years ago and was also the period when the Hmong people in China migrated to Vietnam in large numbers. This was the period when the Hmong people in China enthusiastically responded to the Taiping movement to fight against the Manchu dynasty. The struggle lasted from 1840 to 1868. In later years, Hmong people still migrated to Vietnam sporadically until peace was restored in our country, 1954. From South China, the Hmong people migrated to Vietnam in many waves and many different paths. It was an arduous journey in search of a free and fair life. That is also the process of fighting against oppression and exploitation of the Hmong people in ancient times. Coming to Vietnam. Coming to a new land with almost no human footprint, the Hmong people have found a promising source of life here. It is said that this is a place with many fertile belts. A place with pumpkins as big as cauldrons that wild boars can dig holes into to give birth. It is